Hey everyone, this is Nick. Today I'm going to start a new playlist of videos that teaches you how to make visual reports in Microsoft Word. Now, if you know me, you know that I have not liked Word in the past, and I really love using PowerPoint for reports. So if you want to use PowerPoint for your reports, I'm going to put a link to the video to our Build Your Reports in PowerPoint playlist. I totally recommend that you check that out. But lately I've been doing more reporting in Word, and I've been exploring some of its features, and you know, it's not all that bad. There are some cool things that Word will allow you to do that PowerPoint just won't allow you to do. It's still frustrating to work with objects and charts and graphs and different things that you might, images that you might put on the page. You have to really make sure that you are fixing them in position and anchoring them on the page, but I'm going to show you how to do that in this playlist. But the first little trick that I wanted to show you in this playlist is just simply how to add placeholder text into your Word report. And the reason you might want to do this is just because maybe you want to create a template report for somebody and you don't have their text, but you want to show them what the page might look like with some text. So you've probably seen that Latin lorem ipsum sort of placeholder text. There's some other websites out there that you can go to sort of copy and paste different kinds of fun placeholder text as well. But right inside of Word, you can get your own, you can generate your own placeholder text by just a couple of different formulas. There's two different ones that I know of. Here's the first one. So you're just going to, on the page, in your normal text here, we're just going to type in equals and then type the word lorem and then open parenthesis and close parenthesis and just push enter and see what happens. You get an entire list of a few paragraphs and sentences of lorem ipsum text. Pretty cool. Now the other thing that you can do, I'm going to go ahead and push undo here. You can actually designate the number of paragraphs and the number of sentences that you want by inserting the numbers here outside of the parentheses. So right here, I'm going to say that I want three paragraphs, and I want each of those paragraphs to be five sentences each. And then close the parentheses, and we'll see what happens here. Perfect. You can see that I have three paragraphs, and it looks like everything is five sentences each. That's pretty cool. Now I'm going to push undo again. There's another option that we can do here. Now, if you don't want this Latin sort of verbiage here, you can actually say equals rand, and then I'm just going to open and close the parentheses. We'll push enter, and you can see that you get some English text here with, I'm not sure that any of these sentences make that much sense, but there's some of them do, and you can just see that it'll give you random English words and sentences in your Word report. Let's go ahead and push undo, and let's go do the same thing. So let's say I want five paragraphs, and I want each of these to be five sentences long. I'm going to close the parentheses. And then you can see that I get five paragraphs, one, two, three, four, five, and each of those has five sentences. So this is a pretty cool way that you can add placeholder text into your Word document. And guess what? It works just the same way in PowerPoint as well. I think, let's actually just flip open a PowerPoint slide and see what happens, because I think they may have a little, there may be a little bit, there may be some differences that we want to sort of see. So I'm going to go ahead and open a new PowerPoint slide. Let's go ahead and change this to a text option here. I'm just going to go ahead and in this text placeholder box, I'm going to get rid of this designer pane right here. Right here, I'm going to say equals lorem, open close. There we go. That gives us that Latin text. Let's go ahead and click undo. Now let's go ahead and say, what does it give me when I say rand? Now, I don't think it gives me that same Microsoft sort of video text that we saw in the Word document. I think this is going to give us the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. So that's going to be all of every single word in here is just going to be that one single sentence, the quick brown fox. I'm going to go undo. Let's see if it'll give me that same like paragraph and sentence word. So let's say two paragraphs of one sentence each. Let's just see what happens there. And then I'm going to click enter. Yeah, it gives me that two paragraphs, each one sentence. And the same thing with lorem. Let's go ahead and do the Latin version, lorem, and then type. Oops, that didn't work. I've got to go all the way to the end of that little formula here and then push enter. Let's see what that happens. All right, that didn't exactly work as I thought that it would, because it looks like there are two paragraphs, but each of them doesn't have one sentence. So let's see what if that's the case here. Let's try it one more time. Two paragraphs, one sentence each. Well, Doesn't exactly work, but it does give me two paragraphs. So that's kind of interesting. I'll have to go to the Microsoft support page and look to see if there's any if there are any help or tips on how many paragraphs and sentences you can get in terms of the placeholder text. But going back to our visual reports in Word, this is going to be the first video in this mini series. I'm going to try and post a few more over the next few days just to get you started in how you can work with objects and visuals in Microsoft Word reports. We're going to go through things like the styles headings up here, how to create your own styles, how to manage this style pane. I think that the normal template in Word gives you a lot of different text styles that we really don't need in a document. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to sort of streamline this area here. We'll work with paragraph settings, the line settings. I'll show you how to sort of embed your colors and fonts into your own Word template. And then we'll go into sort of the nuts and bolts of inserting objects and boxes and annotation boxes, callout boxes, narration text, things like that, in addition to images and charts and graphs in your Word report. So watch, I hope that you watch those videos. And if you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to tap the bell next to that subscribe button once you hit subscribe, because then you'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design tutorials in Microsoft products, Excel, PowerPoint, and Word. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I loved making it for you, and I will see you next time.